There's a Buddha birthday celebration in Missouri. Country in the east and even here. This was adopted in 1990.
activity. This is the according to the parade or the Silent Police in New York. And of course, in most of all the police center, I'm some kind of celebration in different ways. So, Amy, what do you have for the next one?
Covert
Buddhism collaboration. What do you have?
I did the Mahayan.
Oh, no, that's okay. You do right. So what do you have then?
Oh, okay. So I was trying to distinguish between the ethnic and the convert, and the ethnic means, just for, I guess I should skip that though. Convert means that they're not necessarily born into Buddhism, so they're not from any of the countries that Theravada Buddhism is. There's hundreds of thousands of people all over the world practicing Buddhism, Theravada Buddhism, that have been converted by, you know, from other religions. Henry Steele Alcott was the first American Buddhist,
yeah.
And he was Theravadan, and he was converted in 1875 or a little earlier, and
yeah.
They founded the Theosophical Society.
Yeah.
They were influenced by Hindu and Buddhist scriptures, and he became a Buddhist convert. There's many more converts, obviously, because anyone from, say, the United States or Britain or somewhere who wasn't born into Buddhism, they would be a convert of Buddhism because they weren't raised that way.
How about nowadays?
You
find information nowadays, people who practice the Theravada traditions, why?
It seemed to be there a lot more in the United States to be a lot more Mahayana than Theravada.
No?
No.
Oh,
is it really?
Why? You know why?
Because of Vipassana? Yeah? Okay. Because Vipassana comes from Theravada. But then Zen comes from Mahayana, so I thought maybe more
right.
People were doing
no.
Zen.
No, not in
Vipassana.
Some meditation is more widespread than the Zen.
Oh, it
the
is?
Zen is also back in the 20th century. Nowadays, in some meditation is more popular. It's more civilized.
Okay.
And do you know why is that?
Why is Vipassana more secularized?
More popular among the American people who like to practice. Do you know why?
Is it easier?
Yeah. That's important.
One's a little bit more strict than the other.
Yeah. What else? That's what you say. Because what happened?
When you move, it's kind of like Roman Catholics. They're
mm-hmm.
really, really strict, and then
that's
Catholicism, and then it spreads out to different
mm-hmm.
sects of.
There's
religion.
No God at all. Especially in some meditation, you don't need to worship Buddha as a God, right? And this is what called. It's self-help, right?
Self-help, yep. That's very popular.
Yeah. You understand what now?
So it's like they took the religion part out,
mm-hmm.
so it's more popular.
And there's some elements of religion there, but not much important than Mahayana than the Vajrayana or Tibetan tradition. In Mahayana and Tibetan tradition, it requires more devotion. But here, you don't need any help. Any kind of devotion. You don't need, this is just your head. You do meditation, calm your mind. You do meditation for your health benefit. You do meditation for controlling your stress. That's all. You don't need to believe in Buddha. You don't need to believe in anyone's. You just follow the practice.
Which is nice. I think that's why a lot of people moved away from religion.
That's the point. Because, of course, some people, they may be frustrated in their traditions because some of them problem everywhere. Yes, sir.
Can you explain that one more time, the difference between self-help and no God.
No, there's no difference. He's saying they go together.
Oh, they go together. Okay. Yeah. Okay, the difference between there's no religion.
Uh-huh. What do you call? What do you call that one?
Yeah, the...
What's it called? The word?
I don't remember.
You just call it at the beginning, remember? At this?
It's easier.
At this is...
People move away. He's talking about...
I can spell it. I what?
Theravada.
Atheist.
Atheist,
there we go.
Spell?
I-E-S-T.
I-E-S-T? Or S-T?
E-I. And then agnostic too.
E-I-S-T.
Like, switch the I and E.
Oh, switch the I?
Yeah.
Okay, okay, good. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
The same people here in America, they follow Buddhism a little bit better, or the type that he's talking about, because there's no God. It's just, they just go into meditation and they, you know, they're helping themselves. They're soothing themselves without the pressures of having to, you know, be under a God or
conform to religious devotions.
Yeah.
Right.
Like go to church every Sunday and stuff. They do it on their own.
What do you mean the devotion? We started before, right? Devotion, the faith, what happened? You need to be lives in something else, right?
Right.
You need to make a conviction. You need to stick with that conviction. And what happened nowadays?
A lot of people don't like that.
Why? Because a lot of problems in the churches. Even in temple too. It's happened everywhere. It happened in any field. Right?
Mm-hmm.
There's two sound coins, right? Good and bad coins. And sometimes people, if they have strong conviction, they stay back with the tradition. Like in politics, right? People stick with capitalism. Other people, they stick with communism. But sometimes they switch the side. Right?
So this stays the same. You're saying this.
He's saying that's Vipassana.
Huh?
Vipassana.
Pasana.
No, Vipassana.
Inside meditation. When you do meditation, you don't need to worship anyone else. You don't need to have the faith. You don't need to have the devotion, conviction. Accept yourself.
Once you learn
and
how
you
to
yourself.
Meditate.
And you can do meditation without any pressure, any times, any place. You don't need to go to the church, you don't need to go to the temple. You have more freedom, that's the point, right? For yourself. It's like the Dhamma there, Burger King there, or all kind of fast food, all kind of restaurant there, but you have choice. Make sense? Mm-hmm. Of course, now the people prefer more choice than only one or two choices in the past, right? So the more freedom people have, the easier for them to pick up the thing that they prefer the most. It's common sense.
Mm-hmm.
It's even in Buddhism too. And they used to tell old people, I mean that the lay people that, well, the faith sometimes, if they could not maintain that kind of faith, it's not easy for them to follow tradition. They have to have strong conviction, motivations. This one, if they could not do now, they may try again. Otherwise, it's okay. They can try yoga. They can try. They go to the gym. They can go to YMCA. That's fine too. This is again in the sense that this is self-help. That's all. It makes sense,
mm-hmm.
Right?
And what is it, self-help? What is it called again? What is the title of it?
Vipassana.
Inside meditation. Remember when we talked last time? Remember? Let me show you this clip. And
it's
you
part
see
of Theravada.
Mm-hmm. Part
of Theravada.
Yes.
Yeah, Theravada.
Yeah, Vipassana is part of it. It's just the insight meditation part.
Okay.
And he's saying it's the most popular in the States because you can do the insight meditation without any religious practice.
Here you see this center run by the lay people.
And over 20 years, this community is
built. He's the founder.
And so it's
Jack
Holfield.
He's founder of this center.
To come back to and remember their heart. Remember that they can be free.
It's a refuge.
It's a place for people who have busy, engaged lives to come, take some time out, and to reconnect with themselves.
Spirit Rock is a Buddhist meditation center in the Theravada tradition. And it has a very unique voice in the Dharma world. Not only does it have a retreat center that focuses on deep, long-term, silent retreat practice, but it also has this community center that's really about how do we integrate Dharma into our lives? How do we actually live this stuff in our relationships, our families, our work, just day-to-day lives?
Are you happy? Do you feel like you have healthy relationships? Are you doing the work you need to be doing in the world? Do you love well? These are questions to ask yourself. And people who tend to be so busy, which is most of us, honestly, don't have a chance to look inward. And Spirit Rock is a place where you can come and stop and see what's going on inside. And in that process, all sorts of transformation can happen.
It beats being neurotic, compulsive, contracted, obsessed with what's next, obsessed with what's happened before, and it creates a kind of openness to be really responsive to ourselves, responsive to life, to think clearly, to speak clearly, to act in ways that are sensitive.
Have you ever noticed the way that you might ask your mind to do something that doesn't do it? Have you ever noticed how often the mind is just running like a tumble dryer, same old thoughts? There's some study that says we think about 70,000 thoughts a day, and like 90% of them we had yesterday.
I mean, most of us are so disconnected from our sense of who we actually are. And so because of that, we act in ways that are harmful to ourselves and to others. We anesthetize ourselves with this whole busy lifestyle. But if we were just to sort of turn around and stop and see what's going on, we might be surprised what we find. We might begin to develop a healthy relationship with ourselves.
The benefit is that you're connecting with a...
Okay, now here. Let me go back to the clip that just showed you. Look. Let me just see. Anyways, okay, anyway, so let me put it this way. In Asia, or even in Roman Catholic, right, the monk, the priest, and central figures in the temple, in the church, right? Mm-hmm. Hold the show, right? But now in the West, the reverse pattern. Yeah, Spirit Rock, they follow the revelations, they run by themselves. And even here, some lady, Ashley, and other lady, go to what for Blueville Mindfulness Living Center. They run by the right people. And I think that's the spirit of American people nowadays, because they want to be free from worshiping or from following some kind of rule. As a teacher, a priest, you understand that? So that's the trend that secularizes the practice of Buddhism. Even in a sense, they still follow the Buddhist principle. You understand that? But in the practice, it's more give toward the lay people. You see the difference to the vision, in contrast with each other, right? That's why especially this kind of insight meditation is so popular. And this one, they consider themselves as Buddhist center. And most of them, of course, they go there, they consider themselves Buddhist. Of course, some of them they may not. I met them when it was in California. And remember I told you about the mindfulness-based stress reduction? Remember? Yeah. This one, again, they don't plan themselves follow this one here, I told you, John Coppins. I just watch this one first and you see and understand why this one is more popular in the West.
That's not where I'm commenting. That's dirt creeping in. Send it running will resolve high traffic foam. Its full power removes 3 times more dirt than vacuum alone. All bone neutralizing head overs. Don't just vacuum clean, resolve clean.
Here with my friend Tavadra. Tavadra, what is mindfulness-based stress reduction?
Well, mindfulness-based stress reduction, or is called MBSR, is an approach to mental health that was developed in the States by Jon Kabat-Zinn in Massachusetts in the late 70s. And initially, it was used to help people with chronic pain, people that the doctors had tried to help through surgery, through medication. But these people were still struggling, they were still in pain, they were still upset, they were still really facing a real challenge with their illnesses. And Kabat-Zinn used some approaches that he'd learned from some of his Buddhist teachers, meditation, yoga, to really help people. And so he established, really for the first time in the West, a whole approach to medical care that was based on methods that originally were used in the Buddhist tradition.
You hear that? So, inside meditation or mindfulness, mindfulness, by stress reduction, that's the root from Buddhism. But they want to take out of the religious elements and use mindfulness as the ways or the tools to help people how to cope with their stress, anxiety, and so forth. That's why it's so widespread. And that's the purpose of Buddhism too. So again, to be monks and nuns, yes, we do voluntarily, no one forces us. And of course, it requires some kind of devotions. For us, yes, for me, I said about my life that comes for practicing myself first to share my Buddhist knowledge with other people. But for lay people, yes, they have all kinds of obligations, right? That you go to school, schoolwork, family obligations, and so forth. Even they may have times to practice or to share with other people. This is some competition. But some one day, lay people, they still devote their times in life, like the one who run the center, that meditation center or mindfulness based instruction. So you see, that's why, yes, sir.
So a lay person is a person that's not a monk or a nun.
Yeah.
It's the lay person.
Yeah, like this person, you can follow 5 pieces. Or even that's up to you. That's just get the moral conduct as human. It's common sense, right?
Mm-hmm.
No killing, no stealing, no sound that, no lie. Universal, right? Everywhere. And if you commit to yourself, you won't be allowed to stay in this kind of human community, common sense. Right? But for the monks and nuns, for the priests, they take more vows, but depend upon their devotion, upon their provision. They take more time and more effort. But again, because at the beginning, the Buddha did not want to establish any religious tradition. You understand that?
You did not want to establish any what?
Religious tradition.
Our religious, okay. Yeah.
So that's why now that people pick up the essence of Buddhism, that's meditation, how to cope, how to deal with life, without any kind of worship, without any kind of confession, without any kind of belief. You understand that? That's the approach of American people in the West. So you will see, if you visit any Buddhist center, you see this especially from ethnic group, like Vietnamese, Chinese, Korean, Sri and so forth. You see, this is all the cultures aspect that tie with that kind of immigrants or ethnic groups. But in some meditation, you see that they push out everything. They send them so that they can focus on what they call meditation. And that's great. And for me, that's great too. Everyone has different views, different approach. Because we have different needs for ourselves. Okay. All right, so the next one, number three, please. Now, what do you have? Are you in room number three?
Yeah, I couldn't remember which one I did, but.
Mahayana?
Yeah, I think I did the convert Buddhism.
That's okay.
If that's the case, let me. Is that in Mahayana too?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Anyone knows number three?
I read a little bit.
Okay, yeah, please share if you have it.
Ethnic Mahayana Buddhists are from, I wrote down all the countries, from China, Vietnam, Korea, and Japan. Or they were born into this tradition. So their ancestry is from one of those countries.
Yeah.
And then it goes into immigrant.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, that's what it means, though, is that you're
mm-hmm.
from one of those countries. You're either from China, Vietnam, Korea,
yeah.
Japan, or your family was from there, and that you practiced Buddhism because it was passed down to you as a tradition in your family.
Yeah, let me show you this clip and you see why. This is the Buddha birthday celebration at my master temple in Ukiah, not in part of California.
Ukiah, California?
Why are they walking
because too many people, so they have to walk up in line before they offer the incense to the Buddha.
Okay.
Too many, they right there, see that?
Mm-hmm.
So this is, you see, with my own experience, it's many years I tried to miss two groups. I failed. You know why? Why? It's not easy. I understand the between. I understand both traditions. In our Vietnamese or Asian Buddhist traditions, we had different mentality from American people. Diversa. When I talk with them, I talk in different ways. Of course, in this sense, it's similar, it's the same, but in different way from American people. Why? Because they have set up belief, set up conviction. You understand that?
Mm-hmm.
And yours is different. So I tried many times, I could not. So of course, I can speak bilingual on the spot, but I couldn't this together. Because one is geared toward conviction, another one geared toward freedom. You understand that? It's not easy.
That's why they always tell you not to talk about politics or religion with anybody.
You can do my mind temple, you see, right? And in our temple, I'm actually in our religion, even in the church, right, tend to do more celebration, tend to do more ceremony and so forth. Elaborate ceremonial celebration. But here is quite different. Unless you follow the Tibetan traditions, you do more ceremony. Yes, sir.
Let me ask you, what do you think about when they heal people in the church, like they touch them and they heal them?
Again, this is the faith. Until the belief, the faith. So it's up to people. If they have strong faith and conviction, they can be healed. That's okay. That's just everything in Buddhism is come from the mind. If you have strong mind, you have strong belief, you can be healed. That's yeah. Why my mindfulness is still with your mind. To overcome your stress, to overcome your physical illness too. Celebration in Missouri.
Churches have bells to make sure people don't fall asleep.
Another one, let me show you this one here.